Aldo Solis from East Palo Alto, California. I wanted to play soccer really bad growing up, and I played soccer here in the community and stuff, but street violence and not the proper guidance, not, you know, the proper tools that, I mean, I guess I would need growing up. I got shot when I was 16, so that kind of put everything on hold for me. I couldn't play soccer anymore how I wanted to. I couldn't pretty much function. I was scared to come out. So people here are, we act tough, you know? Not everybody's a big tough guy ready to hit someone, but you have to be tough because you live, you know, in a community where you have to be a tough guy, or you have to look at least tough, you know, kind of put up a front, so to speak. But then when you go elsewhere outside of where you don't live, you know, and you're walking down the street, people misconstrued it and look at you like, oh, you're a thug, or is he going to steal my purse? Is he going to punch me, you know? So I feel like maybe if people know that, you know, you don't have to always think or be hard. You don't always have to have that, you know, your defense up, you know? You don't always have to be that way. People here in Palo Alto are awesome, you know, they're united people, they're humble, you know, but in a way, yeah, you know, there's not a lot of resources here for people to break out of their normal cycle. Yeah. Your friends are being killed, or your, you know, whatever, your neighbor or whatever, it's like, it's not normal, it shouldn't be happening like that. So if that person behind the gun had the proper guidance, he had the person to talk to, you know, maybe he wouldn't have went down that path. A lot of parents here are single. You know, either they have their mom or they have their dad, or sometimes they don't have either, you know? So that's a big deal that, like, I get back to, they don't have a role model they can look up to. All they look at is, you know, the guys on the streets driving fancy cars, and that's easy money for them. They don't have anybody guiding them, telling them a 9-to-5 is way better than hustling for 2 years and spending 10 years in jail. You know, they see fast money, they want to do it, you know, but there's no one guiding them, telling them stay in school. My experience, like, my parents worked all day, so there was no one at home to tell me, don't go on the street, don't hang out with that crowd, you know, don't do this, you know, do your homework instead, you know, there was no one there over my shoulder looking out if I was doing my homework, you know, so in that sort of way, someone outside of your house, you know, that you can go to, you can talk to, like, a counselor or a therapist or, you know, even a mentor, you know, even that sort of thing can help out in a long way, because you're giving them advice. You know, or you can relate to what they're going through. It can change a lot. It can really change a lot, because you can't talk to your mom about what you went through at school today. You can't talk to your dad about, you can't talk, sometimes you can't even talk to your partner, your life partner about. Sometimes it's good to have another person that you can just, you know, get everything out on the table, and then they can tell you, look, maybe you're looking at things wrong. Maybe, you know, look at it this way. Maybe you can do this differently. You know, then maybe that can just change the way that you think in your mind. Okay, you know, this person's a total outsider, but maybe that can change the way kids grow up. Maybe that can change the way that they think. You know, and not only that, they can help out someone else too.
Yeah.